Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain the differences between transmission control protocol and user datagram protocol. Both these transmission control protocol and user datagram protocol are the protocols at the transport layer of TCP/IP architecture. TCP uses segment as a unit of communication, and the unit of communication for UDP is datagram. When TCP is used at the transport layer, the TCP segment is encapsulated in the IP datagram at the network layer. And when UDP is used at the transport layer, the UDP datagram is encapsulated in the IP datagram at the network layer. Transport layer provides process-to-process communication. Whenever an application is run at the application layer, a process is generated, or when several applications are run at the application layer, number of processes are generated. And transport layer always transmits the information from one process to another process. These processes can be server processes or client processes. Usually the server processes get the port numbers belonging to the range 0 to 1023, which are the well-known port numbers, and the client processes get the port numbers from ephemeral port numbers range from 49152 to 65535. Every process generated at the application is identified by a port number at the transport layer. Now there are some well-known applications which use TCP at the transport layer, and there are some applications which use UDP on the transport layer. The applications which use TCP at the transport layer are the file transfer protocol, which is used for file transferring the files, the telnet application, which is used for remote login, SMTP simple mail transfer protocol, which is used for sending emails, domain name system DNS, which is used for mapping the IP addresses with the domain names, and HTTP protocol, which is used for browsing the web. Now these applications use the well-known port numbers at the transport layer. FTP uses two separate port numbers, 20 and 21. 21 port number is used for the control connection, and port number 20 is used for the data connection. Telnet uses well-known port number 23. SMTP uses well-known port number 25. DNS uses port number 53. HTTP uses port number 80. And all these applications make use of transmission control protocol at the transport layer. Now the applications which use UDP at the transport layer include DNS, DHCP, server, DHCP client, trivial file transfer protocol, simple name management protocol with these port numbers. Now here DNS may use TCP at the transport layer, or DNS may also use UDP at the transport layer with port number 53. The dynamic host configuration protocol server application uses port number 67, and the DHCP client application uses port number 68. Now this was all about the applications which use the TCP and UDP with their port numbers. Now let us understand the differences between the TCP header and the UDP header. The TCP header is having fixed size of 20 bytes. These 20 bytes are occupied by 5 rows each of 4 bytes. So 4 multiplied by 5 is 20. The fixed size of TCP header is of 20 bytes. With options, the TCP header can be extended up to 60 bytes, because options are varying from 0 to 40 bytes. Whereas the UDP header is of only 8 bytes. It has total 4 fields, each having 2 bytes. So 2 multiplied by 4, 8 bytes. Now as the size of TCP header is large, it incurs large overhead in communication. As the size of UDP header is comparatively small, it is of only 8 bytes, it incurs comparatively less overhead in communication. So this becomes one comparative point. Both the TCP and UDP provide the port numbers to the applications, to the server processes and the client processes, because both the headers have the source port numbers and destination port numbers. TCP header has got sequence number of 32 bits. This sequence number always provides the initial sequence number, that is the number of the first byte which is carried in the TCP segment. So TCP provides sequence numbers, UDP does not have any provision to provide sequence number. So this becomes one more comparative point between the TCP and the UDP. TCP provides acknowledgement numbers. TCP sender always checks for the acknowledgements. Unless and until it receives acknowledgement from the other side, it does not send any other segment in sequence. UDP does not have any provision for acknowledgement numbers. It does not wait for any acknowledgement. It does not care about the acknowledgements. It keeps on sending the information. Whereas TCP waits for acknowledgement from the other side, unless and until it receives acknowledgement, it does not proceed to transmit another segment in sequence. Now, these acknowledgement numbers in TCP are cumulative. For example, the TCP sender has transmitted 500 bytes and the receiver has received them successfully, then the acknowledgement number set by the receiving application will be 501, meaning that it has correctly received 500 bytes and now it expects to receive from byte number 1 onwards. TCP has got header length field which specifies the length of the header in multiples of 4 bytes. This header length field is not required in UDP header because the UDP header is always fixed of 8 bytes. There is total length field in UDP header which specifies the length of the header plus data, and as length of header is fixed 8 bytes, we can easily calculate the length of the data from the total length field. Then TCP has got window size field. This window size specifies the size of the receive window. This is used to maintain flow control in TCP. TCP sender as well as receiver has got the send buffers and receive buffers. The sender as well as receiver has a pair of buffers called as send buffer and receive buffer. So as both the sender and receiver has got the send and receive buffers, TCP provides full duplex transmission and it provides flow control using this window size field. There is no window size field in UDP header. UDP does not provide any kind of flow control. TCP provides error detection using checksum field, and the checksum calculation is mandatory in TCP. Minimum level of error control is provided by UDP with the help of this checksum field, and it is optional in UDP. So this is one more comparative point. TCP provides checksum calculation. It is mandatory for TCP and checksum calculation is optional for UDP. Another comparative point is TCP provides flow control. UDP does not provide flow control. TCP provides sequence numbers. UDP does not provide sequence numbers. TCP waits for acknowledgements. UDP does not wait for acknowledgement. As TCP waits for acknowledgement, it provides reliable service. And also TCP is a connection-oriented communication. So always there are chances that the transmitted information is received by the receiver. So the TCP is said to provide reliable service. UDP does not wait for any acknowledgements and UDP is connectionless. So UDP provides unreliable service. Now TCP uses segment as a unit of communication. This segment has got header of 20 to 60 bytes followed by data. Now data size can vary from 20 the TCP segment size can minimum 20 bytes and it can be maximum 65535 bytes. Minimum 20 bytes because the header has to be carried in this TCP segment. Without that the communication is not possible. So minimum size of TCP segment is 20 bytes and maximum size is 65535 bytes theoretically, but practically it is much less than 65535 bytes because this TCP segment is encapsulated in the IP datagram at the network layer. UDP uses user datagram as the unit of communication. In this user datagram, there is a header of 8 bytes followed by data. The user datagram length can be minimum 8 bytes because the header has to be carried in this user datagram, without which the communication is not possible, and the maximum size can be 65535 bytes theoretically, but practically it is much below this because this UDP user datagram is encapsulated in the IP datagram at the network layer. Now both these TCP and UDP make use of pseudo header for checksum calculation, and these pseudo headers verify the source IP addresses and destination IP addresses. The structure for the pseudo headers at for TCP and the UDP are similar, except the protocol field and the TCP TCP length or UDP length field. Both these pseudo headers verify the integrity of the source IP address, destination IP address, and both the pseudo headers have 8-bit field in which all 8 bits are set to 0. The protocol field for TCP pseudo header calculation includes a number 6. The protocol field for UDP pseudo header calculation includes number 17. For UDP, the protocol field value is 17. For TCP, the protocol field value is 6. The pseudo header includes 16 bits of TCP length, which specifies the length of TCP header plus data. The pseudo header for UDP includes UDP length field of 16 bits, which specifies the length of UDP header plus data. So these are the differences between TCP and UDP based on their header structures and based on their unit of communication. Now let us summarize all the points. TCP provides process-to-process communication. Same way UDP provides process-to-process communication, because both these are the transport layer protocols, and main service provided by transport layer is process-to-process communication. So this is the similarity between TCP and UDP. TCP is a connection-oriented protocol. The data transfer using TCP always takes place in three phases: connection establishment, data transfer, and connection release. A virtual connection is set between two communicating entities in TCP. TCP is thus a connection-oriented protocol. UDP is a connection-less protocol. No prior connection setup is required in UDP. As and when the data is available, it is transmitted in case of UDP. But in case of TCP, unless and until a connection is established, the data cannot be sent. The unit of communication for TCP is segment. The unit of communication for UDP is user datagram. TCP provides reliable service as it is connection oriented. It provides reliable service. There are very less chances of the data getting lost in TCP connections. So TCP provides reliable service. UDP provides unreliable service because it is a connectionless protocol. So there are chances that the datagrams getting lost in the medium. So UDP provides unreliable service, and it does not wait for any acknowledgement. So UDP provides unreliable service. TCP implements error control using checksums, acknowledgement, and timeouts. It implements error control using proper error control mechanisms, also using the checksums. Whereas UDP implements minimal level of error control using checksums only, and checksums are also optional in UDP. The use of checksum in TCP is mandatory, whereas the use of checksum in UDP datagram is optional. TCP header is 20 bytes without options. Fixed size of TCP header is 20 bytes without options, but the header can be extended up to 60 bytes with options. UDP header is of fixed size 8 bytes. Now, as TCP header is of 60 bytes with options, the TCP header incurs more overhead in communication, and as the UDP header is less in size, it has a lower size of 8 bytes. So UDP incurs comparatively less overhead in communication. Now, TCP provides flow control. UDP does not provide flow control. TCP provides flow control with the help of the buffers which are present at the sender as well as receiver. Sender and receiver has a pair of buffers, send buffer and receive buffer. So with the help of those buffers, TCP provides flow control. UDP does not have any provision to provide flow control. TCP also provides congestion control by implementing three different techniques. It helps to relieve the network congestion. UDP does not provide any congestion control. TCP is a byte stream service, means the information is transmitted as a stream of bytes. The information is transmitted as, say, first it has 20 bytes, followed by 60 bytes, followed by 100 bytes, and so on. It is a byte stream service. UDP is a message service. In UDP, the information is transmitted as messages. Then TCP provides more services with the use of options, because TCP header has got options which can range from 0 to 40 bytes. So TCP provides more services with the use of options. UDP provides less services as there are no options in UDP. And UDP header size is of 8 bytes fixed. There is no options field in UDP header. So UDP provides less services as there are no options in UDP. TCP provides full duplex communication, because TCP sender and receiver both have the send window and receive window. So it is capable of providing full duplex communication. And it is connection oriented. So TCP is suitable for, TCP is capable of providing full duplex communication. UDP does not provide full duplex communication. TCP uses pseudo header for checksum calculation, same way UDP uses pseudo header for checksum calculation. This is the similarity between TCP and UDP. Then value of protocol field for TCP in pseudo header checksum calculation is 6, whereas the value of protocol field for pseudo header calculation is 17 for UDP. For checksum calculation, the pseudo header field will have value 17 in the protocol field for UDP. TCP offers slow delivery due to ACK mechanism and hence is not suitable for real-time audio and video transmission. TCP always waits for acknowledgments. Unless and until it receives the acknowledgement for the previously transmitted segments, it does not proceed for transmission of the next segments in sequence. So TCP is a slow delivery process, and that's why it is not suitable for real-time audio and video transmission, where timing parameters are very crucial. UDP offers fast delivery, hence suitable for real-time audio and video transmission. UDP does not wait for any acknowledgement, so it does not waste time in waiting for acknowledgement. So it offers fast delivery of information, and hence it is suitable for real-time audio and video transmission. TCP segments are encapsulated in IP packets. Similarly, UDP datagrams are encapsulated in IP packets. So these are all the possible comparisons between the transmission control protocol and user datagram protocol at the transport layer. Thank you.